Hey race fans, and welcome to Iowa Speedway for the running of the Coca-Cola 200 presented by Hy-Vee. Let's take a look at the top 10 starting lineup. In row 1, we have the Naden brothers, Matt Naden on the pole and his brother Jack Naden in second. Row 3, we have Aaron Claiball and Logan Wilson. Row 3, we have Robert Cruz and Jeffrey White. Row 4, we have Jesse Kaplan and Napa Waltner. And rounding out the top 10 is Martin Sakala and Bob Fergus. As we get ready to hear those famous words in motorsports.
Drivers, start your engines!
And the trucks are rolling. It looks like we don't have any problems with any trucks. As the pace truck already leaves the track, this is going to be a 20-lap shootout. As we're getting started with the Coca-Cola 200. Heading to turns 1 and 2, Matt Naden is getting a good lead. Coming up in second is Aaron Claiball, and coming in third is Robert Cruz in the 7 truck. And well, here comes Jesse Kaplan under Jack Naden. That's going to be for 4. As Matt Naden will lead this first lap. And whoa, Aaron Claiball, he's trying to catch up to Matt Naden on the inside. As we now go to Aaron, comes in, whoa! And oh, Aaron Claiball, Matt Naden, oh! Oh, wow! Oh, the yellow flag is out! Whoa, what in the world? Aaron Claiball just got a little too close to Matt Naden, and that caused a huge wreck. Oh, Ralph Green got involved too! Oh, the yellow flag is out. And here's what happened to cause that first crash. Here's a better view. We saw this wreck in aerial coverage. I guess Aaron Claiball didn't have enough grip going into turn 3. And he just slides into Matt Naden, who was leading the race. And the both of them just slam into the wall. And if you think that wasn't enough, Matt Naden just barely hits his brother Jack, and Logan Wilson, he just slams into the back of the 83. And there goes Napa Waltner, he got involved. There's Andre Johnson, there's Jordan Hetzer, Tim Nyro 22, and whoa, there goes Ralph Green, Carson Valdez, and Alex Drayton. All three of them turned into the wall and wrecked. And Carson Valdez also got hit too. And there goes Dougie Shears, he also got a piece of it, as his truck slams into the front of Ralph Green's. Whoa. That 31 Excite Chevy Silverado is destroyed. There's Aaron Claiball. He's going to smoke down into pit road. He was trying to battle for the lead. There goes Matt Naden. Andre Johnson's truck came to rest. Napa Waltner drives away. Carson Valdez. Ralph Green is smoking, Alex Drayton is smoking, and whoa, Hoover 75 also got a hit. What happened to him? And here's something I missed. In front of all that carnage, this happened. Apparently, Nick Knotts gets into the back of Jay Bruce in the 10. Raven Ladderer's Barney Ward, Alex Catana, they don't have anywhere to go. As Nick Eggleston goes down onto the apron to dodge out there. And it looks like Hoover 75 gets into the aid of Barney and Ward, and he just slides up the track as Jay Bruce seems to recover, and he drives away. And here we are back at Iowa getting ready for the restart as they go down the back straightaway. Robert Cruz, Jesse Kaplan, Jeremy Britt, Martin Sakala, Trent the Hedgie, Jack Naden, Ken Griffith, Joseph Lombard, last week's winner, Tyler Williams, and Jeffrey White. That is your top 10 at this time. and to check on the trucks that got involved in wrecks. Logan Wilson is out. Andre Johnson is out. Matt Naden is out. Ralph Green is out. And Aaron Claiborne is out. As the pace truck leaves the track, we're going to restart this race. And Robert Cruz, he gets a good start off the pack. And whoa, already trying to go for second is the 22 of Jeremy Britt. And there goes, and whoa, Marcel Kyler almost got into Jesse Kaplan, but Jesse Kaplan saves it. As we head back to the front, Robert Cruz, he's still leading this thing. And Jeremy Britt is trying to catch him in that 22 truck. And there goes Trent the Hedgie in the number two. And whoa, we're trying to have a battle for the lead now. Jeremy Britt is trying to pass Robert Cruz for the lead, and he got it. As he goes way to the outside, oh, and that's going to open the door for Trent the Hedgie in the two truck. Trent the Hedgie will lead that lap, but look who's behind him. The 18 of Martin Sakala, who came so close last week to win. And he takes the lead from him. But here comes Jesse Kaplan in the 57 truck. And whoa, do we have another wreck? I don't think so. The yellow flag's not out. We're still green. And right now, it's all about Martin Sakala. Martin Sakala is leading this thing. And whoa, we're trying to have another battle for second. It looks like Robert Cruz and Tyler Williams are trying to get up there. Tyler Williams won at Martinsville. And here comes last week's winner, Joseph Lombard, in the three truck. He is under Jeremy Britt. I believe that is for... And whoa, whoa. And oh, no. Oh, some of the trucks have slowed down. And Joseph Lombard spins around. And whoa, whoa, more carnage. Oh, the yellow flag is back out. The yellow flag is back out. Whoa, what happened? Yellow flag is back out. And here's what happened about that second caution. Coming out of turn three and into turn four, it looks like Robert Cruz and Tyler Williams get stuck together in turn four, and that caused the both of them to slow down a lot. And behind them, it was Joseph Lombard and Jeremy Britt trying to challenge for fourth. And the two of them just get together, trying to go four wide in front straight away. Jeremy Britt couldn't hold his line, and he gets into the front of Joseph Lombard. And that, in turn, spins him around along with, well, Jeremy Britt, he gets hit. Robert Cruz also spun around. And there goes Red Bell. Dark Spike driving by. There's Jack Naden and Trent the Hedgie. He is stuck behind Robert Cruz as he slides. And there were more trucks that got involved. And whoa, Bob Fergus got into the back of Jeffrey White. And Team 48 Lowe's gets into the back of Trent the Hedgie. Jack Evans gets into the back of Ken Griffith. Till Night Rose 22 gets into Team 48 Lowe's. Jay Bruce. Ty Norton, Jasmine Acosta, Nick Knotts, Nick Eggleston, Dougie Shears again, Barney Ward again, Raven Ladderus, Hoover 75, and there's Alex Drayton too. And also involved in the first wreck, Napa Waltner. Whoa, they all just rear-ended each other in the front stretch. It's just a big pileup. And there goes Carson Valdez in 46. I think he avoids all this. Yep, he slows down in time. Sorry about that light. That's one of the lights on the track. And he slows down enough to not hit Barney and Ward in the A truck. And here we are back on the caution as we are getting ready for the restart as they go to the back straightaway. Martin Sakala, Jack Richards, Joseph Lombard, Red Bell, Jeremy Britt, Tyler Williams, Jesse Kaplan, Dark Spike, Lisa Shears, and Jack Naden. That is your top 10 at this time. And to update on trucks out of the race, Hoover 75 is out, Jack Evans is out, Alex Drayton is out, Team 48 Lowe's is out, and Napa Waltner is out. As the pace truck leads the track, we are going to restart this race with six laps to go. Can Martin Sakala hold out? Will Jack Richards, Red Bell, or Joseph Lombard get their second truck wins? We're going to find out as Martin Sakala will lead them off. We have 6 laps to go. If Monster Carlo wants to capture his first win, he better keep his lead. And oh man, Red Bell! Oh, she slides in the back straight away. Is the caution out? Yep, it is. Yellow flag is back out, and I think that's going to end the race. I'm not sure. And here's what happened to cause the third caution. Trying to move up in position, Jeremy Britt gets into the back of Red Bell. And that causes Red Bell to slide in the back straightaway. Tyler Williams had nowhere to go. The same goes for Jesse Kaplan. And well, a dark spike gets into the back of Jesse Kaplan. And Jack Nathan gets hit as well. And well, he gets in front of Jordan Hetzer. And also Trent the Hedgie in the 2 truck. And whoa, Cole Landing also gets hit. Adam Feigl gets into the back of Connor Breeden. Tim Feigl behind his own brother. As Jordan Hetzer gets turned. Megan McCoy. And whoa, Dougie Shears gets into Nick Eggleston. And Jasmine Acosta gets into Dougie Shears. And we had yet another pileup. There goes Jay Bruce, Ty Norton, Nick Knotts. Whoa, Ty Norton got off the air. Barney Ward gets into the back of Nick Knotts, and Carson Valdez gets involved yet again. And up ahead, Raven Lateris slides into the wall. As there goes the Feigl brothers. Tim Feigl gets a little hit. There's Megan McCoy and Trent the Hedgie. And wow. And there's Cole Landing under the apron. There's Tim Tyrell's 22 behind King Griffith. And whoa, in the front, Jesse Kaplan turns Robert Cruz right in front of Jeffrey White. I guess he had a little vendetta with him. I don't know. Hey, race fans, and welcome back to Iowa from the third caution. It looks like we're only going to restart this race with only 1 lap to go. Too bad we're not going to have a green-white checker. Martin Sakala only has to complete this lap one more time to capture his first win, but he's got to go out against Jack Richards, last week's winner, Joseph Lombard, Jeremy Britt, Lisa Shears, Red Bell, Tyler Williams, Bob Fergus, Robert Cruz, and Jeffrey White to do it. To check on the updated cars. Well, it's a lot. Jasmine Acosta, Nick Eggleston, Nick Knotts, Ty Norton, Alex Katana, Dougie Shears, Cole Lanning, Adam Feigl, Dark Spike, Jack Nathan, and Jesse Kaplan are out of the race. And Barney Ward is a lap down. We're only going to have 1 lap to go. Just one more time. As Martin Sakala will lead them off. But Jack Richards is going to be charging. And right now it's all about Martin Sakala. But Jack Richards is right there. Going into turn 3 and out of turn 4, Jack Richards is not going to be able to make it, because coming out of turn 4, Martin Sakala will win the Coca-Cola 200. Martin Sakala defends against a charging Jack Richards to have his first Mountain Dew Co-Red Truck Series win. Second place is Jack Richards. Third place is Jeremy Britt. Fourth place is Lisa Shears. Fifth place is Red Bell. 6th place is Joseph Lombard, 7th place is Tyler Williams, 8th place is Robert Cruz, 9th place is Ken Griffith, and rounding out the top 10 is Bob Fergus. As we look at Martin Sakala taking his victory lap, he deserves it. He withstood 3 wrecks, 3 cautions, and a very strong number 29 truck. Congratulations to Martin Sakala for winning the Coca-Cola 200 presented by Hy-Vee. Okay, the Coca-Cola 200 presented by Hy-Vee at Iowa Speedway. We had three cautions for 12 laps, and we had three lead changes between four drivers. Martin Sakala dominated this race. He led the most laps. He withstood two cautions and captured his first win in the Mountain Dew Co-Red Truck Series. Jack Bridges started in 25th and finished second. Jeremy Britt ends up third. Lisa Shears fourth. Red Bell fifth. Last week's winner, Joseph Lombard, in sixth. Superdog 316 finishes seventh. Robert Cruz drops to eighth. Ken Griffith ninth. And Bob Fergus, he pretty much stayed the same. A good run today for Connor Breeden, finished 13th. The same goes for Raven Lateras. He started in 36th and ended up with a top 15. And here is the rest of the field. Barney Ward finished the race two laps down after starting in 34th. He will finish 21st. Now, all the trucks 22nd on back will have DNFs. This was a bad day for the Naden brothers. They both started on the front row, and Matt Naden finished 39th, and his brother Jack finished ahead of him in 23rd. Also a bad day for Logan Wilson. He got involved in that first caution, I believe. And also Ralph Green. It was a bad day for him. It's not always good starting in the front row because you'll never know what'll happen. And here are the point standings after 11 races. Red Bell is still the Mountain Dew Co-Red Truck Series leader, but look who's behind her. The person who just won, Martin Sakala, he's moved up to second. Jack Bridges is in third, Trent the Hedgie fourth, Connor Breeden fifth, Lisa Shears sixth, Joseph Lombard seventh, Jeremy Britt eighth, ninth Jesse Kaplan, and 10th is Ken Griffith. Well, that's going to do it for Iowa. We will see you next time at Nashville once again.